We undertook a very thorough process of working out what's the best way of actually purchasing light rail.
If you want to look at project finance, you can go back to the Romans to find examples of PPP style contracts being put in place.
You're actually engaging private sector capital, so the private sector's money, not the government money, initially.
Put very simply, it's really a long-term contract between the government and a private provider of infrastructure. So it's a contract that requires the private sector to design, build, commission, and then operate the infrastructure over a long period of time, usually 20 plus years. And what that does is it increases the level of risk transfer that you can achieve through the contract, and it places a lot of ownership risks in the hands of the private sector. So the private sector becomes an owner and operator of the infrastructure.
You're asking the private sector not just to build something, but to build it, maintain it, and operate it to agreed standards over 25 years.
In the case of a light rail project, you would expect there to be urban designers, light rail designers, rolling stock designers and manufacturers, but you'd also expect there to be an operator, facilities maintenance companies, and they come together to form a consortium and share those risks amongst themselves.
A PPP certainly makes bidders think about who they're partnering with. From a bidder's perspective, they want to make sure that they have the best team possible available to them. Imagine I built a house for you, and you don't have to pay anything to me until I've actually built the house. But for the next 20 years, I offer to make sure that the house is kept in good order for you. So I pay the phone bills, I pay the Foxtel bill, I pay the water bills, I pay the electricity bills, and periodically I will refurbish elements of the house for you. So I'll ensure that the kitchen is up to date and the bathroom is up to date. And at the end of a 20-year period, I'll give the house back to you and it will be in excellent condition, fit for you to continue living in for a great many number of years thereafter. One of the benefits of doing this is that ACT government's not in a position where it is making a large single capital payment up front. It's paying for the service over time, just as people are using the service over time.
What it means for government is a different style of management. It's less hands-on than if government were delivering it, this piece of infrastructure itself. And so it involves less resources, but involves different types of resources. So it involves probably a higher level of commercial and financial skills and expertise than perhaps the traditional kind of route would.
So there's some very strong commercial financial drivers to make these projects work.
What it does is transfer a good deal of the commercial and the technical risks to do with delivering infrastructure. So government is much more likely to get on time, on budget delivery of infrastructure through a PPP than under more traditional forms of contracting and procurement. By doing it as a PPP, you know, Canberra is likely to get best value for money, and it's going to get a facility which is world class for the life of the project.
Authorised by the ACT Government.